فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The next root cause of deviation is اشتمال الباطل على شيء من الحق. That amalgamation of the truth with falsehood. When you find and you see that the truth is there, but there's a lot of falsehood in it, people tend to fall into it because they observe and they only see that there is truth in it. As we previously mentioned before, al-batil al-mahd, if the batil is pure batil, then the fitrah doesn't like it, so people are not going to go towards it. So shaitan knows that and he's fully aware of that. The fitrah won't go towards batil, which is mahd, pure batil. So what would he do? Shaitan and his army and his followers, what they will do is that they will take that batil and they will cover it, they will mix it, they will amalgamate with it some truth and some guidance. So now that the fitrah is in a state of confusion, and this is something that many people will go for, especially if the person doesn't have, what you call it, he doesn't have the knowledge and the ability to understand. If you look at many people today, when you come up to them and say to them, يا إخوتي الكرام, أيها الأحبة الفضلاء, my beloved brothers and sisters, television is haram, ما يصلح, get rid of this, take it out of your houses, what will they say to you? يا أخي, I watch the news. They'll tell you the good that is in it. And he will forget the point, which is what? All of the evil that is in it. He just wants to stick to the few good that is in it. Ya akhi, the shaitan will not bring to you something that has batil mahab. That's not what he does. Rather, every single thing that we see today has some form of good in it. Al-khamr has good in it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, يسألونك عن الخمر والميسر قل فيهما إثم كبير ومنافع للناس وإثمهما أكبر من نفعهما. The khamr has what? Has a manafع. Benefits, has good, it has good for it. So the people are always fooled with this idea, is that the batil being mixed up with some truth in it is one of the things that makes many people fall into the falsehood and the misguidance and be deviated from the truth. لذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية, he says البطل لا يظهر, the batil does not become clear and apparent لكثير من الناس, for a lot of the people. Why? أنه باطل. Many people, the falsehood does not become clear to them as falsehood. Why? لما فيه من الشبهة. Because there is in it شبهة. شبهة here means what? What does the word شبهة originally mean? You know what شبهة originally means? شبهة in the Arabic language is the mixture of truth and falsehood. That's what شبهة means. There is falsehood mixed with a bit of haq. So the many of the people cannot see the falsehood لِمَا فِيهِ مِنَ الشُّبْهَةِ, because there is a mixture. There's a mixture of what? Batil and haq. They can't see the batil. فَإِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ الْمَحْءَ الَّذِي يَظْهَرُ بُطْرَانُهُ لِكُلِّ أَحَدٍ. Because the batil, which is pure batil, everybody can see that. Everybody say, that's clear batil. And everybody walk away from it. لا يكون قولا ومذهبا لطائفة تذب عنه. So that because of that, because the batil, which is clear, you won't find any group of people ever fighting for it. لا يكون قولا, it's never a speech, nor is it a methodology, a batil which is mahd, لطائفة, a group of people, تذب عنه, which defend it. You will never find that. Rather what? وإنما يكون باطلا مشوبا بحق. But it's the batil that has haq mixed with it, is that which you would find people fighting for it, a group defending it, arguing for it. كما قال تعالى, as Allah said in the Quran, لِمَ تَلْبِسُونَ الْحَقَّ بِالْبَاطِلِ وَتَكْتُمُونَ الْحَقَّ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. Why do you mix the haq with falsehood and you hide the truth and you all are his state of knowledge of it. ولذلك many of the people today, when you look at them and the path of Ahlul Bid'ah, you find that this is the reality of the situation. So the person turns away from, the batil that is there. Turn a blind eye and just focus on the good. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the 35th volume, page 190, he said, وَلَا يَنْفُقُ الْبَاطِلُ فِي الْوُجُودِ إِلَّا بِشَوْبِ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. He said that the batil will not spread and it will not grow into existence and into the world today, إِلَّا بِشَوْبِ مِنَ الْحَقِّ, unless it is, it has somewhat, some form of truth in it. كَمَا أَنَّ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَبِسُوا الْحَقَّ بِالْبَاطِلِ. Just like the people of the scripture, they mixed haq with batil. بِسَبَبِ الْحَقِّ الْيَسِيرِ الَّذِي مَعَهُمْ. Because of the truth, the little truth that was with them. يُضِلُّونَ خَلْقًا كَثِيرًا عَنِ الْحَقِّ الَّذِي يَجِبُ الْإِمَانُ بِهِ. And because of that, they misguided so many people from the truth which it was obligatory for them to believe in. وَيَدْعُونَهُ إِلَى الْبَاطِلِ الْكَثِيرِ الَّذِي هُمْ عَلِيهِ. And they were truly calling them to what? The batil, which was large in its amount, in which they were upon. So listen to this. The people of the scripture today, Ahlul Kitab, if you look at them, do they have more haq or more batil? More batil. And they'll keep saying, they'll only talk to you about the haq which they will see that you accept. But what is it that they are trying to push you to, and what is it that they're really calling you to? The overwhelming batil which they are swimming in. So once you do accept them, are you with me? You're actually now facing and you're dealing with batil that is high in its density and high in its amount. And that's the one, as I said to you brothers, al-batil, the batil which is mixed with haq, huwa alladhi yusamma shubha. It's the one that's referred to as shubha. Scholars call this shubha. And if the shaytan and those who work for shaytan are able to get to you in no end, in any of the other root causes, they will try this one the most. ولذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن القيم رحمه الله, شيخ الإسلام ابن القيم says in his كتاب مفتاح دار السعادة, the first volume, page 140, he said, والشبهة وارد يرد على القلب يحول بينه وبين انكشاف الحق له. He said the shubha, it falls into the heart and it becomes an obstacle between the truth and his heart. It will actually be an obstacle that stands between the heart and the truth. So he can never see the reality of the truth because the shubha is right there in front of him. And the scholars by that, they warned against the scholars about the glitters and the glamours of falsehood and how beautiful it may look. ولذلك سفيان الثوري رحمه الله, he says, ما من ضلالة, there is no misguidance إلا عليها زينة, except there's beauty with it. فلا تعرض دينك, do not present your religion to لمن يبغضه إليك. Do not present your religion to, do not put your religion to a person who hates it, who hates what you're upon and the path in which you are upon. And he also hates for you to be in the good that you're in. He dislikes that for you. So we have to understand that the batil and the haq being mixed is one of the root causes why so many people today will say to you, Ya Akhi, what about this? What about that? And I mentioned this story many times. Shaykhuna, Al-Shaykh Abdul Kareem Al-Khudayr, Hafidhahullah, he used to have a phone. He had a phone. And he got rid of that phone and he bought himself a smartphone. So when he got himself the smartphone, you know, he was using it one day and randomly a woman popped up on the screen. You see? And I wouldn't be shocked if the woman was just, you know, her hair was showing. Simple like that. The way we would say simple. So he got rid of the phone. He said, get away from this. I don't want this anymore. So he got rid of the phone. Pay attention. And he said, I got rid of the smartphone and I went back to the dumb phone, which is the old phones that we used to use. Then he said something very powerful. He said that Because so many people said to me, Shaykh, but what about this masalih? What about these benefits? I listen to Quran with it. I do this and I do that. He said, دَرْءُ الْمَفْسَدَةُ أَوْلَى مِنْ جَلْبِ الْمَصْلَحَةِ. Repairing the evil takes precedence in bringing about good. Yes, but he saw it to be what? There is nothing except that it has in it what? Good and what? Evil. And that's the majority of the people. When you say, Ya akhi, this is haram, this is la yajuz, the sharia doesn't permit this, they will say to you, akhi, look at the khayr that's in it. Did you think to yourself, the shaitan is going to bring you batil mahr? Batil, which is pure batil, Ya akhi, even the Christian Jews will take that. No human being will take that, let alone a Muslim. Batil, which is clear batil. Everybody, because the fitrah won't allow that. The only thing that can be used for anybody, whether it be a Muslim or not, is what? The batil that has some haq in it. That's the one that it will spread to you. So my beloved brothers and sisters, be careful, protect yourselves. And make sure that you don't get fooled by that. The next root cause that brings about deviation and diverts a person from the straight path is خلطة أهل الباطل, free mixing with the people of misguidance, people of falsehood. يا إخوة, free mixing and intermingling with someone or something leaves effect in your heart. It leaves stains in your heart. And as we're all aware of, we as human beings, we copy one another. We imitate each other. We mimic one another. And if you look at prophets, they were not made to go to become shepherds for camels. Because the character of the camel is what? It's tough, and it's also stubbornness, and also arrogance. Where would this come to them from? It would come to them from the animal. It's haywan, it's not even a human being. By free mixing with this animal, this person starts picking up attitudes and personalities and starts to think in a particular way. Allah says in the Quran, الْأَعْرَابُ أَشَدُّ كُفْرًا وَنِفَاقًا وَأَجْدَلُ أَنْ لَا يَعْلَمُ حُدُودَ مَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ. We're stubborn people. Whereas the ones that are ra'il ghanam, those who go after sheep, goats and lambs, they're simple, they're humble, and they also are good leaders. And the animal, the sheep, the goat. So every prophet that came, as the prophet told us, he says, وَلَمْ يُبْعَثْ نَبِيٌّ قَطْ. A prophet was never sent out, إِلَّا كَانَ رَاعِيًا لِلْغَنَمِ. He was a ra'il ghanam. The messenger told us. The reason is because animals have effect on you. فَمَا بَالُكَ. Then what do you think? A human being who can talk to you, who can converse with you, who can get his point across to you, who can convince you. صح? Animal can't convince you, it's just an animal, right? وَلَذَلِكَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ ابْنُ تَيْمِيَةَ, sorry, شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ, sorry, الْإِمَامِ الْحَافِظِ ابْنُ رَجَبِ الْحَنْبَلِي in his kitab لَطَائِفُ الْمَعَارِفِ. Because of that, الْحَافِظِ ابْنُ رَجَبِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ in his book لَطَائِفُ الْمَعَارِفِ page 138, he says, إِنَّ النُّفُوسَ تَتَأَسَّى بِمَا تُشَاهِدُهُ مِنْ أَحْوَالِ أَبْنَاءِ الْجِنْسِ. Ibn Rajab said something very powerful. He said that the soul, it copies, and it copies what it sees from the situation of its people. We copy one another. If you live with the people who are generous, you tend to become generous. If you live with people who are stingy, your upbringing has an effect on you, isn't it? Does it not? So, خلطة أهل الباطل, mixing and free mixing and intermingling with the people of falsehood is something that what? It affects the person's perception and it affects the person's heart and implementation. ولذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية said, فكم من الناس, how many people, لم يرد خيرا ولا شرا حتى رأى غيره. How many people who didn't want evil? They didn't want good. Did they want evil? Nor did they want good. But they saw somebody other than them. Especially if that person is your same age or somebody's close to you. يَفْعَلُهُ You saw that person do something. فَفَعَلَهُ Then you do it. فَإِنَّ النَّاسَ كَأَسْرَابِ الْقَطَعَ مَجْبُولُونَ عَلَى تَشَبُّهِ بَعْضِهِ بَعْضٍ People are like, we copy each other, we mimic one another. How many times have you gone to the masjid, you sat down, you weren't planning to pray sunnah, you saw somebody who you were with pray sunnah, you just stood up and started praying sunnah. It wasn't part of your plan. Yeah? But it made you stand up and pray that sunnah. Where did that come from? Who are you copying? But that is bad. It's good to copy the Muslims, and it's good to. But why? How did that happen? Sah? It's because we copy one another. ولذلك the Salaf of هذه الأمة, they warned against sitting with the people of innovation and sitting with people of falsehood. Bandar ibn Hussein, as Imam al-Dhahabi brings in his Sirah ala min Nubala, he said, صحبة أهل البدع تورث الإعراض عن الحق. He said, the companionship and the friendship, okay, of the people of innovation, تورث الإعراض, it inherits you and it makes you turn away from the truth. Imam Malik رحمه الله, he said, الدلو من الباطل هلكة. Getting close to falsehood is a destruction. والقول في الباطل يسد على الحق. And a statement of guidance, misguidance, it blocks you from the truth. Fudayl ibn Iyad said, من جالس صاحب بدعة. Anyone who sits with a person of innovation, لم يعطى الحكمة. Wisdom is not given to them. If you sit with a person of innovation, you're never going to be given wisdom. So wisdom is actually in opposition to sitting with innovators. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, that is Ighathatul Lahfan, the first volume, page 55. إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ إِلَىٰ اَعْتَادَ السَّمَاعَ الْبَاطِلِ Ibn al-Qayyim says, if the person makes it a norm in listening to falsehood, وَقَبُولِهِ and the acceptance of it, أَكْسَبَ وِذَلِكَ تَحْرِيفًا لِلْحَقِّ عَمْ مَوَاضِعِ It will inherit you by default. You would start to have these characteristics, which is what? Distorting the truth from its places. You start to distort the evidences. When it's sent your way, you start to find misinterpretation to tamper with it. Where did this come from? Where did it come from in, what do you call it, distorting the evidences? It's صُحْبَةِ أَهْلِ الْبِدَعَ It's been friends and companionship with the people of falsehood. So that is why many people, if you sit with them and you look at them, their problem came from that. As I said previously, Abdul Razak ibn Hammam al-Sana'ani rahimahullah, the issue of a tashayyu', they said it slipped into him. The tashayyu', of course, is of different levels. But they asked him, this is the teacher of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Abdul Razak. So they asked him, they said to him, okay, listen, where did this come to you from? Because all of your shuyukhs and all of your teachers are what? The people of Sunnah, the ulama of Sunnah. Where did it come to you from? And he mentioned a particular person who he was affected by. He said, this person whose manners I respected, and the way they carry themselves I respected, had affected what? Had an effect on me. And so look what happened. By respecting this person's etiquette, bid'ah steeped into him. And falsehood got into him. And that's very, one of the things that divert a person from the truth. Also, one of the things that, ya ikhwati al-kiram, which is a root cause, for deviation from the truth is كثرة أهل الباطل when the people of falsehood are large in number. If the people see كثرة القائلين, he sees a lot of people saying a statement, or he sees a lot of people attributing themselves to this deviated group. A lot of the people, this would carry them to, and it will push the person to believing that this is the right and that this is the truth. And it then makes him feel that the people who are the minority, the ones who are less in number, are the people who are what? Who are misguided and they are corrupt and they are overzealous and that they are confused. And this, my beloved brothers and sisters, this argument that the majority of the people are upon this, this is the proof of the misguided people. That's their argument, that's their belief. Wherever you find them. من قبل ومن بعد. Before and today. They're still the same, they still use the argument. Allah said about them, Fir'aun said this. This is a Fir'auni argument. What did he say? فما بال القرون الأولى. What about the generation before Musa? If you're coming to us and say this is what's right, then what about the previous people, all of the thousands of people and millions of people before you? Where are they, do they go? They're misguided, you're guided alone? Same argument. هذه حجة فرعونية. It's a Fir'auni argument. ولذلك الله تبارك وتعالى, when you look at the Quran and you do تتبع of the Quran and you do observation of the Quran and you do إدامة النظر, consistently looking, you find that the Quran rather rebukes the majority. Allah says, وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَن فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّكَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. If you obey the majority of their people, they will misguide you from the straight path. Allah also says, سبحانه وتعالى, وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. The majority of the people are not right. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He praises the minority. He says, وَقَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِ يَشْرَقُونَ. Little from my slaves are those who show gratitude. Allah also says in another ayah, وَإِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْخُلَطَاءِ لَيَبْغِي بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَقَلِيلٌ مَا هُمْ. Little are they. Which ones? Which who are little? The ones who آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. وَقَلِيلٌ مَا هُمْ. Little are they. So this ideology that you find that akthariya, majority, this is, as I said, it is a hujjah fir'auniyah that many people try to use. And it is, without a doubt, it is from the root causes that divert a person from the truth. Because a person starts feeling ghurba, alone, by himself. Me, us, me and these people, are we the only guided people? نحن على حق. Are we the only people upon the truth? My beloved brothers and sisters, the day of judgment, a prophet is going to come and no one's with him. He's alone. Does that mean that prophet is not upon the truth? And Nabi, وَلَيْسَ مَعَهُ أَحَدٌ. A prophet is going to come and no one's with him. He's alone. The whole ummah of his time don't believe in him. Does that mean that prophet is upon his guidance? And the people, I didn't say one person followed him or two people followed him or three. We're talking about a whole qawm. They didn't have amongst them one person to accept the prophet. Another prophet is going to come. والنبي ومعه الرجل والرجلان. A prophet will just come with one person. Another prophet is only going to come with two people. All of that is going to happen. So this argument that it's about the quantity and the amount that you have to prove that this is the right, that's not the truth. Rather, the majority of the people's heart is inclined to, as we said before, the truth that's mixed with the haq. They already, because listen, the sawarif that I'm mentioning, all of these things that divert you from the haq, that I'm mentioning to you and I'm telling you about, brothers and sisters, is so much in amount that majority of the people fall under these. So that's why it's easy for them to be swayed, to be diverted from the straight path. It's little who've come with the characteristic method of knowledge. We mentioned that. Jahl, is it common amongst the people or is knowledge more common amongst the people? Exact. So the people of knowledge are little in number. So by default or by from the get-go, you can see that the root cause of deviations going to be present in the people, in the majority of the people. But in that case, some people, it gets to them when they look at the people's comments. And it gets to them when they find the people's response. Yeah, you're talking to a people, لا يعرفون يمينهم عن شمالهم. They don't know their right hand from their left hand in the religion. They don't. So when you take their thoughts and then you take onto their expressions and their ajib, don't take that into consideration. Even when they agree with you, don't take it into consideration. Are you with me, brothers? The understanding and the comprehension of the truth has nothing to do with what the people think, or else we fall into the democracy we criticize. ولذلك العلامة الموفق أبو محمد المقدسي رحمه الله حكاية المناظرة في القرآن page 57 to page 58, he says something very powerful. الموفق أبو محمد المقدسي رحمه الله. He says, ومن العجب أن أهل البدع. He said, he's fascinated. He said, ومن العجب, what is fascinating is أن أهل البدع, the people of innovation, يستدلون, they use as evidence, على كونهم أهل الأهل الحق بكثرتهم. They use as a proof that they are the people of truth because they are large in amount. وكثرة أموالهم, and that their money is the most, that they have more money than. You see? وجاههم, and they say we have, we're in charge. Where are you in charge? وظهورهم, we're the mainstream, we're more apparent. We're on the news. We're on the dish, for example. I mean, what do you call it, the television. We're more, what do you call it, running projects and programs. You see, look at the amount of people we can bring for Salatul Eid, مثلا. This is what they will say. ويستدلون على بطلان السنة, and they will try to prove the falsehood of the Sunnah بقلة أهلها وغربتهم. Because their people are little in amount, and that they are strange. وضعفي, look how weak they are. فيجعلون ما جعله النبي دليل على الحق. So what they do is they make a proof, that which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a proof, they make it a, the Prophet made a proof, the qaleel, the little, as a proof that this is the haq. They do it the opposite. فيجعلون ما جعله النبي. So they make that which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made as a proof, they make it علامة على السنة, دليل على دليل, دليلا على الباطل, an evidence that is false. فإن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, because the Prophet told us, أخبرنا بقلة أهل الحق, because the Prophet told us that the people of truth are little in amount and little in number. في آخر الزمان, when before the hour strikes, at the ending of time. وغربتهم, and that they are strange. وظهور أهل البدع وكثرتهم, and that the people of innovation are going to come apparent and they're going to be large in amount. ولكنهم سلكوا سبيل الأمم في استدلالهم. But look what they did. They traded on the path of the nations before in using as evidence على أنبيائهم, their prophets. You're using the Fir'auni argument he used against Musa, you're using against the people of the Sunnah. That's what they use. بكثرة أموالهم وأولادهم وضعف أهل الحق. That you have more money, you have more children, and the weakness of the people of the truth. So this is something that fascinated Abu al-Muwaffaq Muhammad ibn Qudamah al-Maqdisi rahimahullah, which is that Ahlul Batil, wherever you find their brothers, wallahi, this is common. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of it. This is common. قَلَّ أَن تَجِدْ. Little do you find them say in an argument except that, oh, so only this little masjid. They'll say that to you. They'll say to you, four or five of you guys, أَنَا فَضَ حَقْ. That's what they'll say to you. When reality is not only four or five, they will make even less than what it really is. Huh? We're already little, don't make us even little. That's what they'll say to you. So when they say that to you, and they'll say to you, look, we're running everything. We're not running projects. We're the ones that are running all these ISOCs. We're the ones who are running, you know, these retreats and whatnot. We're the ones that people know of. That's us. And then they try to prove that the Sunnah is batil and the people of the Sunnah, بِقِلَّةِ أَهْلِهَا, because they're little in number. وَغُرْبَتِهِمْ, that they are strange. وَضَعْفِهِمْ, that they're weak. That's what they try to do. So they try to make an evidence opposite to that which the Prophet ﷺ made evidence. They make their dalil kathra. The Prophet made the dalil on what? Qilla. Those who are little in number, that they are the people of haq. They try to make the opposite. So they do opposition of the Messenger alayhi salatu wassalam. And they take the path of the previous misguided nations against their prophets. ما نراك اتبعك إلا الذين هم أراذلنا بادي الرأي. We don't see anyone following our prophet, except those who are the most dim-witted ones amongst us. The lowest ranked ones are the ones who follow you. Our messenger, what did they say to him? The slaves and the women are the only ones who follow you. To our prophet, عليه الصلاة والسلام. That's what they said. But in that, some of the prophets, they said to him, your people are so poor and your people are so unattractive and just, like, we can't sit with them. Just make us another day which we can sit with you. Ah, that's what they said. And Allah told the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, don't turn your eyes away from these people. Don't ever dismiss these companions, whether they are little in number, whether they don't look appealing as the kuffar do. Don't. These are the ones I'm pleased with. They might not look appealing, they might look out of shape, they might have a ghurbah. That's what ghurbah brings. Strangeness brings that. Because they're living on scripture and nusus, textual evidence. قال الله قال الرسول. And they're living at the wrong time. They're living with the wrong people. These are the ones whose logic keeps changing and their rationality keeps changing and how they observe things and their perception keeps changing. These people are going to be strange because they're living 1,400 and something years ago. What the Prophet was living on is what they want to live in the 21st century. It's a praise for them. And that's why the Prophet said, بدأ الإسلام غريبا. بدأ الإسلام غريبا. Islam started off strange. When it first came, look at what happened in Mecca. How strange they were looked at. وَسَوْفَ يَعُودُ غَرِيبًا كَمَا بَدَأ. It's going to go back to that strange. That's how it's going to be. Then the Prophet said, فَطُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَى. Glad tidings for the strangers, that is. Glad tidings for those people. In another hadith, the Prophet said, يأتي, he said, يَأْتِي عَلَى النَّاسِ زَمَانٌ. There's going to come a time, الْمُتَمَسِّكُ بِدِينِهِ كَالْقَابِدُ عَلَى الْجَمْعَةِ. There's going to come a time where the one who's holding onto his religion is like he's holding onto hot charcoal. Hand is burning, but he's still not going to let go. He's not going to let go. It burns his hand, the charcoal is burning his palm, but he's still holding onto it, he's not going to let go of it. And that's what's happening to this individual. He's being insulted, he's being ridiculed, but he's still not going to let go of that sunnah. And he's still going to stick to it. SubhanAllah, if you look at these people, the things that they belittle them is what? Let me guess. Short thought. Miswak. Things that are sunan, the sunnah of the messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, is what they make their jokes and their ridicules. Don't worry. You're upon a path that you don't need to worry about. Now, some may argue, this is a side point, some may argue, is that how do you then reconcile between the statement of Hiraql, in which he said to Abu Sufyan? Because when Abu Sufyan and Hiraql had the discussion, Abu Sufyan was asked, Ayazeeduna, does Muhammad's followers increase in number? Abu Sufyan said, Naam. Hiraql then says, وَكَذَلِكَ الْإِيمَانِ. Iman is like that, it increases in number. So you're now saying that the people of Haqq are little in number. But Hiraql and Abu Sufyan, when they're having their dialogue and their discussion, the answer was that he said to him, what? Ayazeeduna, do they increase? And he responded by saying, Naam. And then Hiraql said a powerful statement. He said, وَكَذَلِكَ الْإِيمَانِ. And Iman is like that, increases. But you're here saying that we're little in number. So there's two answers for this. Number one is that Hiraql did not make only this the sign of the Prophet as a prophecy. Rather, he made other things, and he mentioned other things in which he used عَلَى صِحَةِ نُبُوَةِ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Sahih? He mentioned other points.